Welcome back. Just in time for the weekend, let's get some education about wine. Have you seen this label, certified biodynamic? Sounds like it would have some extra punch to it. We want to find out exactly what it means. Jade Helm, a sommelier and author of TastingPour.com, joins us to explain this term, biodynamic wines. I'd never really heard of it
either.
Before.
Right, so it's really cool. A biodynamic vineyard will meet the requirements of organic, plus they take this holistic view of the farm. And so they use the interaction of the soil and the plants and the animals and even the moon phases to create this sustainable farming environment.
So how do the animals come into play then? Do I want to know?
You do want to know. It's really cool. That's the reason we have these fantastic cow horns on our table.
Kathy thought she was drinking out of it.
I was like, that is so cool. Give me a horn.
Everyone should play with one. Yeah, so what they do on a biodynamic vineyard is they smush cow poop into the cow horn.
Okay.
These are clean. And they bury them in the ground.
Okay.
And it sounds really
weird. Fertilizer.
Yes, when they dig it up, the manure has become this super concentrated, all natural, non-synthetic fertilizer that they can use in their vineyard. So it makes sense. It's just kind of a different way of going about it.
No, everybody uses natural fertilizer. They just do theirs a little more dramatically.
Right.
How common is this?
Well, actually, in Oregon, if you look at the whole world of biodynamic wines, Oregon is holding its own.
There's a
pretty good percentage of Oregon wineries doing this, but that being said, there's not that many overall. So in the double digits.
What have you brought us today?
I have brought this gorgeous Pinot Gris from Keeler Estate Vineyard.
I love Pinot Gris. And this is from
Willamette Valley. And to me, this just tastes like a spring day. And it's kind of what it's like being at Keeler. It's a really pretty vineyard. Mm-hmm. And a lot of the biodynamic vineyards are pretty because they have different plants and animals and things.
That's really nice.
Isn't it lovely?
Very, very light. That is from Keeler. And what's the next one
Okay, wait for it, guys. Mm-hmm. This is from Cowhorn Vineyard.
Of course it is. Mm-hmm. Where's Cowhorn Vineyard?
It is in southern Oregon.
Perfect.
And this is a white blend. It's called Spiral 36.
Tastes nothing like that cowhorn and what might have been in it.
It doesn't. Really good. And it's, to me, that's like spiced baked apple and orange blossom.
It's very pretty.
And,
although I love this Keeler. Mm-hmm.
They're both so great.
This is very distinct.
Mm-hmm. You get really pure fruit.
It does really farm biodynamically.
Mm-hmm. Yes. And then we have to have a Pinot Noir. This is also Willamette Valley. This is from Brooks Winery. It's called Rostabon.
Love the name.
So this is their Pinot Noir. And to me, this just has so much fresh cherry.
Oh, I definitely get a cherry in that.
And the smell.
Yes, it's gorgeous. Now, I do have bad news.
Uh-oh.
We're tasting our wines on the wrong day. So there's a calendar for biodynamics, and it tells you what day you're supposed to do different things in the vineyard.
Oh, this with Friday the 13th?
We're in trouble.
We're doomed.
We already opened the umbrella.
And it tells you the best days to drink your wine, and this is not it. So.
Oh, look. Every day is a good day to drink wine.
I think so.
And unless it's biodynamic.
Yeah. Can you imagine how much better they would taste if we tasted them on the right day?
So, for example, the right day might be, is it a certain day of the week
or a date on the calendar?
So they use the moon.
The moon.
And they divide the month into leaf, root, fruit, and flower days. And so the fruit days are supposed to be the ones that is better to taste wine. This is a leaf day, but these are still gorgeous.
Boy, I can barely wait till 5 o'clock. Yeah. I'm going to wait for the calendar. Jade, thanks so much for coming in. TastingPour.com is where to find out more information. Really fascinating.
Yes, well, something to toast is a great anniversary.